so hardworking man. Even he used not to come this way, loving his country. He said he would love his country more than relatives. So we are so happy for him to love the country as the father did.
Many things. General Kale Kayihura has achieved so many things for the people of Kisoro. But the most important is, you saw Bafumira now educated. They are very educated. We had a problem of jobs for our children who graduate. But he managed to recruit them in the police, in the army. You go to you go and check records in the Uganda police. You go and check the records in the army. Bafumira, so many. So that one is a very big milestone.
The other year, last year, Kayihura was one of the generals who was supposed to retire. But unfortunately, it did not happen. But today, we are grateful that General Kayihura is going to retire.
The list that was out, the army who were retiring, when I saw the name of General KK and President Museveni had okayed the list, I was very, very, very happy, because this was a pledge which President Museveni assured people of Kisoro when he was campaigning.
Residents in his hometown of Kisoro believe General Kale Kayihura served the nation diligently and deserves to retire as he wishes. They have welcomed the news of his coming retirement approved by the president. Kayihura faces charges of failure to protect war materials, failure to supervise police officers, and kidnapping, which led to his arrest in 2020. He has been on bail since then. In his last days as the Inspector General of Police, Kayihura had proposed holding suspects with capital offenses for up to 90 days without trial. After his arrest, Kayihura was detained at the military police headquarters in Machindia for 76 days without trial. He was later arraigned in the court-martial and charged with three counts, including failure to protect war materials, failure to supervise specialized units under the IGP's office, and aiding and abetting kidnapping. Report by Job Namanya for the news in Kisoro.